Hunt 'em Big with Steve Bartilla. Brought to you by Bush Hog, Easton, Reconyx, Heater Body Suit, and by Wildlife Research Center.
No ifs, ands, or buts about it. One of the hugest keys to successfully harvesting whitetails is to go undetected. If they smell you, you know what? The gig is up. Their best defense weapon happens to be their nose. We cannot even comprehend how well they can smell compared to us. I mean, it's almost like that is their main form of communication. Now, is the odors they deposit and their ability to pick them up and decipher them. Okay. It is, simply put, their greatest defense mechanism. So, how do we go about not getting winded? There's really two ways. One, play the wind. You play the wind right, you don't have to go ahead and go through a bunch of odor control steps. You really don't have to. There's all sorts of hunters out there that have been very, very, very successful over the years, never spending a cent on odor control technology. Never going ahead and washing like I used to with baking soda. And I'll tell you what, it ain't really that easy to go ahead and wash your hair with baking soda, but gol darn it, I did it. I did it over and over and over again until I started using scent killer products. But you can hunt the wind effectively. Remember, in the morning, because the ground is hotter than the atmosphere, it heats the air and the thermals tend to carry your odors up. So you can get away with a lot more in the mornings than you can in the afternoons, where all of a sudden now that air is dropping. That air is dropping and it's carrying your odors down. Try to set up stands where there's no way deer are coming anywhere from this direction. That way you have a safe wind. Remember to use the wind on your way to your stand, and if you're going to hunt that stand again or that property again, on your way out. You want the wind to be blowing your odors away from deer at all costs. That means that bottoms, tight bottoms, are out of the picture. They're not an option because the wind's just going to sit there and swirl like that on you no matter what the wind is down there. Okay, you really want to hunt high because you have a much more stable wind direction. But if you've ever stood around a campfire or you've ever stood around a barbecue pit, you realize that wind is not a constant. Just because it's blowing in your face for the last 10 minutes doesn't mean it will be a minute from now when Mr. Big is coming out. Okay. What you're doing is you're playing the odds. The wind is generally coming in this direction, so I don't want deer behind me. I want the deer to come through out there. The other option is to take odor control to the extreme. That means treating every single item you bring in the deer woods with you. I wash my glasses every single time before I go out hunting. I take that shower every single time before I go out hunting, and you know what? I use a treated towel that is treated every bit as seriously as my hunting clothing is. You know, the worst thing you can do is grab that towel that's hanging in the stinkiest room of the entire house that was washed with a scented detergent, a scented fabric softener, and now you're spreading perfume all over your body. Why did you waste all that time showering? Why'd you waste all that money on scent killing products? Okay. If you're going to try to defeat a whitetail sense of smell, I'm here to tell you, it can be done. But it's not going out and buying one product. There is no silver bullet to this stuff. What it is I use scent killer, I use scent lock, and I treat every single item that goes in the deer woods with me. That stinky grunt tube, my binox, my bow, my boots, everything, because that whitetail does not care if it is smelling your breath, your hair, that stinky grunt tube that has all that bacteria in it from blowing in it time after time after time again, or anything else. Please, please make me walk back to the truck to get my gutting knife and a drag rope, because that means it's been a good day. I'm going to take the bare minimum with me out in the woods, because every item I bring out needs to be treated. You do that and you can defeat a whitetail sense of smell. Or you play the wind.
Hunt 'em Big with Steve Bartilla. Brought to you by Bush Hog, Easton, Reconyx, Heater Body Suit, and by Wildlife Research Center.
Whitetail sense of smell is an incredibly powerful tool. We must defeat it in one way, shape, or form in order to get a shot on that whitetail. You can either play the wind, or you can take odor control to the extreme, but do not believe the hype. There is no one product out there that if you buy it, you use it, you're done, you're good, you're golden. That is baloney. It's marketing baloney. You have to treat every single item you bring in the woods with you. You do that and you can defeat a whitetail sense of smell as well.